Hello guys, welcome to another statistics video, and today we'll be learning what standard deviation is, what variance is, how to find them, and what they actually mean. All right, so here you see two formulas for the standard deviation and the differences between them. We'll examine in just a second, and this is a data set for which we'll be finding the standard deviation in just a little bit. So first, let's start by defining standard deviation and what it actually is. Now, the standard deviation is the square root of the variance. You cannot talk about standard deviation without variance, and it's at the heart of the thing itself. Now, what variance is essentially the average of the squares of deviations in a data set. So this is expressed as this formula over here, so you can see that this is our any data point in a data set. For example, it could be 0, 1, 3, and this is the mean. And so we subtract the mean from our data point, then we square that value, and we divide the sum of all of those deviations by the total sample size. So in this case, it would be 10, so we would divide it by 10. However, a very important difference between this and this, so this one is denoted by sigma and this one is denoted by s, is that this formula over here calculates the standard deviation and thus the variance as well in a sample. And this formula calculates the standard deviation in a population. And the difference arises from the fact that the sample, which is much smaller than the population, gives us a less accurate numerical value. And that's why we have to subtract one here, since if the number here becomes larger, or the number here becomes smaller, the number here becomes larger, and we need to account for this smaller sample size to get a more accurate result. Whereas with a population, we know the entire population's values, and we can calculate more accurately. So this just accounts for the bias that we have with a smaller sample size. And now that we've clarified all of those things, I also need to point out that this is a symbol that means mean for the population, so population mean, and this X with a hat is a mean for the sample, so a sample mean. Now we know the two formulas. We can calculate the data set over here, and let's assume, to give it some more context, that this is the number of pets some of your classmates have. So this data set here includes 10 data points, so that's probably not the entirety of your class, much less so the entirety of your school. That's why we're going to use this formula over here, which calculates for the sample, which would be much smaller than the entire population. And we will start by calculating the variance. So we will take all of those data points and subtract them from the mean. Well, actually, we'll start by finding the mean first. And then we'll calculate the standard deviation and we'll discuss, you know, the repercussions of it. So, I will spare you the time by telling you that the total number here would be 20. So that's the all of the pets shared between your classmates, at least in this data set. So it's 20 divided by the total number of students that you've quizzed about their pets, and that gives you the mean of 2. Now we know the mean, we can calculate our variance. And what is it going to look like? We have 4, since 0 minus 2 squared gives us 4, and we do the same for the rest of the numbers. And here we have 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 16 plus 0 plus 1 plus 0 plus 0 and plus 4. Where would I write that? Let's see here. And that gives us our sum of x minus x hat. Now we need to divide that by n minus 1, or in our case, 9. So the sum of all the numbers here should be 28. And 28 divided by 9 is approximately 3. Since 3 by 9 would be 27, so pretty close. All right, so we have our variance, and now we calculate the standard deviation. So for that, we need to take our 3 and just draw a square root, which should give us something around 1.7, I believe. All right, and this is your standard deviation. Now, what could that mean in terms of this particular problem? You know that the mean in our case would be 2. That means that more or less on average, your friends have about 2 pets. And if you take any particular friend of yours from this data set, for example, this guy or gal that has, for example, a dog, a parrot, and a hamster, you know that the number of pets they have falls within 2 standard deviations, or within actually 1 standard deviation from the mean. Since, for example, if this is 2, our mean, and 1 standard deviation above that would be 3.7. And since they have just 3 pets, they fall within 1 standard deviation of the mean. Whereas somebody who has 0 pets, so 1 standard deviation below would be 0.3, they are somewhere here. So that means they fall within 2 standard deviations from the mean. And that's what makes it so particularly useful. And that's what actually statisticians use standard deviation for. And hopefully now you know what variance is and what standard deviation is, and you can apply that to your own statistical pursuits. Thank you very much for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and like our video, and stay tuned for more videos. Bye-bye.